All right. Welcome, everybody. Welcome back for another episode of Think On It. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. Yes. How are you doing, man? It is so good to talk to you. It's been a while.
It has been a little while, yeah. Actually, but it's really great to be back in here and doing this again. And we are shooting in a new location today, for those who may have noticed. It is really awesome to be shooting here in the theater of the kids' building.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. This place is full of energy. You can almost sense it when you're in here.
You really can. I like to do as many things as possible over here because this is the fun building.
Oh, it is. Yeah, absolutely. They call it the fun building because all the fun happens here.
Absolutely.
But yeah, you can imagine this place full of kids.
Right.
And it is nuts. Have you been in here when there's a lot of kids in here?
Yeah, a few times. I run screaming every time.
So. Yeah, no kidding.
No, I'm just kidding. Okay. They have so much fun in here. I have kids that are that come in, they get to be in this space and they have so much fun. And my kids go home talking about it every single week and they absolutely love it. So.
Yeah, and it's not just, I mean, hear this. It's fun, yes. I mean, it is a blast. We want kids to know, but we don't want the Bible to be boring.
No.
It's a sin to make the Bible boring,
yeah,
and especially for kids. And so we pull out the stops
to make
this what it is. And so we do everything we can to enhance the way we present the Bible so that when kids hear it, they are just enamored and excited about learning about who God is and who Jesus is. So it's great.
And they absolutely are. So, yeah, so the last podcast that we shot, we actually did with Wade and Charlene and talked about, I said this, you heard that, but talked a lot about family and kids and students and all that stuff. So here we are. I figured it would be fun. This is not a green screen behind us. This is actually the setup for what Sunday has looked like for the last few weeks, ever since we did Camp Fair Creek.
Yeah, and boy, was camp ever, I mean, it was something else.
It was amazing.
They had such a great time, and the camping theme was everywhere, all throughout the building, but especially here on the stage.
Yeah, it was really, really cool. Got to be able to be a part of that, too. And again, kids had a blast, and they had a lot of fun. But I know my kids went home every single day talking to me about the stuff that they learned when they were here. And that's obviously more important to me than any of it. But again, but I don't want them to be bored with it either. I'm glad that they have fun and I'm glad that they learn things. It's good to have both.
We kind of joke about it. You know, when the kids come, you know, sometimes kids will come to a place like church or whatever, and their parents go to drop them off and they're like crying and don't want to stay.
Right.
We would rather they cry because they have to leave.
That's exactly right. Yes. Yeah. I think my kids did that a couple of days. They're like, why do we have to?
Yeah, absolutely.
Going home with you is boring. No, I'm just kidding. So, you know, as we're talking about some of the things that are going on here at Fair Creek, and there's this word that you have now said a couple of times when it comes to Sunday mornings and even probably just in conversations with people, and that is the word relaunch is a word that I think people have started to hear. And so I just kind of wanted to ask you a little bit about that. What do you mean by a relaunch? What are we doing? What is your vision for what will happen as a result of this relaunch that is coming? How will we be different? And I don't mean different like we're changing a bunch of things about our church, which is something that you'll probably get to, but you relaunch for a reason because we're trying to take a different approach or do something different. So what's your vision on that? What do you mean by that?
Well, okay. What really started this whole thing really goes back to when we went into lockdown, and obviously we're out of church for several months. And even when we came back last August, we came back August of 2020, so we had been out about 4.5 months. And so we felt like, you know, it just, there wasn't a fast return of people. Although a lot of people still watched online, a lot of people stayed engaged with the church. But what we found out was that the momentum that we really had prior to the whole thing, we had kind of lost that because we were moving. We were considering adding a service to our schedule. There were just a lot of things that were going on, and that we thought, well, this is going to be great. You know, we were making plans. We had a strategy for, you know, 5 years out, and then that just all got blown up.
Yeah.
I mean, there wasn't anything left of it, basically. And so really came up with this idea after prayerfully considering what could we do to capture some of that excitement and momentum we had before. And so after that period of time of praying and just considering it, talking to staff, talking to leaders in the church, what we came up with and what I just felt was important was, what if we were to consider it this way? We were like planting a new church, but we were doing it with 1,000 people. And we were doing it with already an established group of people to be our staff.
Yeah.
And people, you know, there was plenty, you know, the resources in place that we could use and do some things. And not only just plant an in-person church, but what if we were to plant a church with an in-person campus and an online campus?
Yeah.
And in doing that, we kind of broaden the opportunity and everything. So when we say relaunch, we just, it is a term that a lot of people maybe are using for different things,
sure,
but you almost really have to start over. A lot of even businesses and any organization, and the church is not exempt from that, need to kind of start over in a way. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, in a lot of ways, COVID stopped a lot of people's lives. And so this gives us a chance to really re-engage people. And that's really what we're calling the series we're going to start in August, is re-engage.
Yeah,
because that's so cool. Really what we want people to do. So, we're just trying to take advantage of the year of lockdown and all of the things that COVID brought to us. And when it's a worldwide pandemic, it affects everybody a lot of different ways, financially, their time. But also, I think it even brought people to a point to realize they've got issues that they didn't realize were issues until this happened.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Revealed some things.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So now we're just taking advantage of that with that relaunch.
Right. No, to me, it's a tremendous opportunity, though, to kind of rally everyone together, mm-hmm, and say, you know what?
Yeah.
We know that the last year was hard on different people for different reasons, all kinds of different things. And so it's just an opportunity, again, to rally people together and say, let's move forward. If there's some things that we can do differently, if there's some things we can do better, if there's some things that we absolutely need to keep doing because they were awesome, let's go through all those things and let's really rally together, link arms, and move forward.
All throughout this time period, we have been asking that question, what could we do better? And so that was another part of this, was if we can do something, if we're doing it good, then why can't we do it great?
Yeah.
Because if we're considering that we're doing everything we do for God, then he deserves great. You know, he deserves our best, mm-hmm, not just, you know, good enough.
Good enough,
or
yeah,
whatever. And so that's another reason, too. It gives us a chance to step back, look at everything we're doing.
Right.
And everything we've done. And just because we did it a certain way before the lockdown and the pandemic came on the scene, just because that's the way it was doesn't mean we have to continue doing it that way.
Right.
And so it has really allowed us to step back. We're actually going through every ministry leader. You know this as one of the ministry leaders. Yep. You know that we are going back and all the leaders in our church, people who are serving in ministries, and that's just it. Anybody who's serving in our church, we regard them as a leader. And so as leaders, we're going back and retraining and just saying, what can we do to take it to a great ministry, a great way to reach people, continue to put that idea of being for our neighbors out there. That's so important.
Yeah.
So all of that is a part of this relaunch, to just take it from good to great. We don't want to just come in and settle for just good enough.
Right. Right.
We want it to be the best it can be.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, I've heard it said before, and I think this is absolutely true, that doing something well, and you know, you get into routines, which is fine. You get, mm-hmm, into a routine, you find something, you start a new project or whatever it is, and you get it to a point where you're doing it well, and you think, good, this is where I wanted to get it to, right? And so you're doing it good. But I've heard it said that good is the enemy of great, and that becomes part of the problem. And that, you know, it's like, well, we're doing it good, we're doing it well, why mess with it? It's working and it's good. But could it be great? And what is holding us back from that? Because especially if it's just a few small steps or tweaks, why wouldn't you take those steps in order to make it truly great? And you know, and again, like you said, God deserves the very best that we have to offer. He deserves for us to strive to make things great, not just okay, not just good enough. And good is not bad. Good is good. But again, why not make it great if you have the ability to do so? And sure. And this whole situation has given us the ability to maybe hit pause or completely stop on certain things because it just stuff stopped. Well, now it's like, okay, we're not in those same routines that we were in. So good doesn't have to be acceptable anymore. We can say, if we're going to move forward, how could those things that we were doing that were pretty good, how could they be even better?
And I think that's what makes it worth doing then.
Yeah.
I think if we just went back to doing it, you know, same old, what would end up happening is I think people just, you get kind of apathetic about it. You get complacent, even cynical perhaps. And that's the last thing we would want anybody to do, because what we do here, we're presenting Jesus.
Yeah.
And we're honoring him. And so if we present him in a cynical, half-hearted way, that's not someone I would want to follow.
No,
you know, if I were looking in or coming into the church, and I wouldn't want to follow him if every his followers only want to do it halfway. So this was a great way for us to just step back and make sure that we were doing it the best possible. And to actually even add some things that we needed,
yeah,
take away things that we didn't need,
sure,
you know, and really reconsider that. It changes, you know, not always fun, but in this case, quite honestly, the change has really had an upbeat effect,
yeah, absolutely,
on the church and on people and on us as a staff, as the elders, the leaders in the church. It's just amazing,
yeah,
how that's happened.
Yeah, I think it's this may have taught some of us the importance of being able to be open-handed, even with the things that we do and that we work in or work with, just to say, you know, we're not trying to make it personal. If something that we were doing wasn't working real well and there's something else we could do that would work way better to achieve a similar goal, is not taking those things personally and saying, well, but that was my thing and I really want to hang on to that thing, as more being of the mindset of, I want it to be great. I want it to be the best that it can be. And if something else would do a better job of, you know, reaching people than what I was doing, then let's do that. Right. And being open-handed enough to, and humble enough, really, in my opinion, honestly, to say, I'm willing to do whatever, change whatever, keep whatever, we'll do the very best job of, you know, the mission and vision of what we're trying to do here as a church.
Well, I think you just hit on something that I think we could come back to for future podcasts, which kind of fun to talk about the staff values.
Yeah, that would be great.
Because one of our staff values is to approach everything with an open hand.
Yeah.
Because we don't want to be so tight gripped to something that we can't change it to be better.
Yeah.
You know, and sometimes someone else's input, collaboration with other team member or you know, someone else gives us something that may improve it far beyond what our experience or what we may understand or even our skill level.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so it's great to see God use people in your life to be able to help you, but you've got to be willing to be open-handed.
Right.
And so that's a good point. So maybe we should come back
yeah.
to that sometime.
I think that'd be a really great thing to talk about and just something really cool to let people in on and to know that the values that we hold as a staff and why those things are important.
So, right. And they would be very transferable. You know, we kind of taken it from an example of another church.
Right,
and so it gives us the opportunity maybe to pass that on and maybe, you know, even in people in their business
world, those principles would hold very true too, I think.
Absolutely.
So no, that'd be really great. Thanks for watching this clip from the Think On It podcast. If you would like to hear this episode in its entirety, check us out on Spotify, Google Podcasts, or Apple Podcasts, or just click on the link below to listen to the entire episode. Thanks again for watching, and see you next time.